Hello student, welcome for today's practical session. In today's practical session, we are going to demonstrate effect of salivary amylase on hydrolysis of starch. Professor M.G. Shinde, Department of Pharmaceutical Chemistry, KKO College of Pharmacy, welcomes for today's practical sessions. So learning objectives of today's practical is to know the aim, different reagents, principle behind today's practical, to know the procedure, observations and result, and finally we have to see some viva voce questions. So the aim of today's practical is to demonstrate the effect of salivary amylase on hydrolysis of starch. For this we required following requirements: apparatus and glassware, we required thoroughly washed dry test tube stands, beaker, glass rod, water bath, etc. In chemicals, we required 1% starch solution, iodine solution, 5% sodium chloride solution, buffer pH 6.8. There are some preparations like 1% starch solutions. We have to dissolve 1 gram of starch soluble in suitable quantity of boiled distilled water and make up the volume with the quantity sufficient 100 ml. We have to prepare 5% sodium chloride solution. For this, we require to dissolve 5 gram of sodium chloride in suitable quantity of distilled water and make up the volume to quantity sufficient 100 ml. In the iodine solutions, we have to dissolve potassium iodide in about 20 to 30 ml distilled water. Then we have to add iodine granules and heat gently with the constant mixing until iodine is dissolved. Dilute to 100 ml with the distilled water. Now the principle of today's practical. Very first, salivary amylase is an hydrolytic enzyme that breaks down the polysaccharide into starch amylose, polysaccharide like starch amylose dextrin, and yields a disaccharide that is maltose. Salivary amylase is an enzyme that is produced by the salivary glands, formerly known as ptyalin. It breaks down starch into the maltose and isomaltose. Amylase, like other enzymes, work as a catalyst. Amylase digests starch by catalyzing hydrolysis, which is splitting by the addition of water molecule. Hydrolysis of starch yields polysaccharide of gradually diminishing molecular size and ultimately acrodextrin and maltose. The presence and absence of starch can be confirmed by several tests such as iodine test. So various stages of hydrolysis of starch. Starch gets hydrolyzed by the action of salivary amylase and produces various products gradually, which on reaction with iodine gives various color. Starch with iodine gives blue color, while further hydrolytic product of the starch is amylodextrin, which gives violet color with iodine solution. Next hydrolytic product of this amylodextrin, that is erythrodextrin, which gives red color with iodine solution. And final hydrolytic product of the starch, that is acrodextrin and maltose, which does not give any type of color with iodine solution. So that is, achromic point is achieved whenever there is complete hydrolysis of starch into the acrodextrin and maltose. Now let us see procedure. Very first up, we have to collect saliva. We have to dilute 1 ml of saliva with the 5 ml of distilled water, and we have to use the saliva solution as saliva mixture. We have to take 5 ml of starch solution in test tube. Then we have to add 2 ml of buffer pH 6.8 and 1 ml of 5% sodium chloride solutions. We have to incubate this mixture at 37 degree for 4 to 5 minutes. Simultaneously, we have to take 0.5 ml of iodine solution in 10 to 12 tubes, place them in a test tube stand at a room temperature in rows. Now, we have to add 2 ml of saliva in the tube containing reaction mixture, which was kept at 37 degree. Mix it well and take immediately a drop of mixture and add into the first test tube containing iodine solutions. We have to repeat the same procedure after every 2 minutes, each time adding the reaction mixture to the next tube contains iodine solution placed in the row. Note the time taken to achieve the achromic point, that is no color with iodine solutions.
Everyone, welcome for today's practical. Aim of our today's practical is to demonstrate effect of salivary amylase on hydrolysis of starch. So for today's practical, the requirement is, first of all, we require glass vase, a dry test tube, pipettes, bar, water bar, thermometer, test tube stand and holder. Similarly, we require chemicals, 1% starch solution, 5% sodium chloride solution, buffer solution of pH 6.8, iodine solution and distilled water, etc. Now, our aim is to demonstrate the effect of salivary amylase on hydrolysis of starch. Now, salivary amylase is the enzyme that is present in our normal saliva. This alpha amylase that catalyzes the hydrolysis of alpha 1 4 glycosidic linkage present in the carbohydrates, that is amylase and amylopectin, which are the two components of carbohydrates. These are to be hydrolyzed with the help of this enzyme alpha amylase that is present in salivary saliva. Now, hydrolysis of this starch is polysaccharide, that is gradually diminishes the molecular size of the starch. Very first of all, it is converted to the amylodextrin, then erythrodextrin, then aquadextrin. Starch as such, when treated with the iodine, it shows blue color, while the amylodextrin shows violet color, erythrodextrin shows red color, and the last molecule, that is aquadextrin and maltose, that shows a achromic point, that is no color with the iodine solutions. And this is the basic principle behind to study the effect of salivary amylase on the hydrolysis of starch. So we will actually perform the practical at laboratory level. Okay
student, now we are actually going to perform the practical in laboratory. So here, as early discussed, we require the following requirements. Very first of all, we required glass vase and chemicals. In chemicals, we required, first of all, we have to require 5% sodium chloride solution, iodine solution, 1% starch solution for today's practical, buffer solutions, buffer pH 6.8. Apart from this, we required glass vase, in which we required a set of test tubes, which is required for taking the solution of iodine. Also, we required two test tubes, for one for collection of saliva and one for preparation of mixture. Now the first step is collection of saliva. Very first of all, we have to rinse our mouth. Then we have to take a clean test tube. We have to place a tongue of tip of the tongue on the test tube, and we have to collect some amount of saliva. That is, we have to collect, if we are collecting 1 ml of saliva, then we have to dilute it with 4 ml of water, that is 1:5. We have to take the solution of saliva. So this is the preparation of saliva solution. Now, after collection of saliva, the next step is, we have to take a new test tube. We have to take 5 ml of 1% starch solution. Now we are going to take 5 ml of 1% starch solution. So first step is collection of 5 ml of 1% starch solution in the test tube, mark as A. Now second is, we have to take 2 ml of buffer solution of pH 6.8. So this is 2 ml of buffer pH 6.8, and last step is, we have to take 5% NaCl solution. We have to take 1 ml of 5% NaCl solution. Now we have to keep this solution for warming to the room temperature, that is up to the 37 degree. So we will take this and put into the water bath.
we have to incubate this solution for 4 to 5 minutes. We have to maintain the temperature up to the 37 degree, not more than 37 degree. As this is winter season, we have to require to maintain the temperature 37, because the normal room temperature is below 37. So we are using the water bath here. This is up to 37. We have to keep it 4 to 5 minutes. Please.
1 minute.
Now the next step is we have to take a set of 6 test tubes for taking the iodine solutions. So in each test tube we have to add 0.5 ml of iodine solution. Test tube containing equal amount of iodine solution. Now the next step is we have to take a saliva solution. We have to take 2 ml of saliva solution and we have to add it to a reaction mixture which is incubated for 4 to 5 minutes at 37 degree. So we are going to take near about 2 ml of After taking this saliva solution, we have to mix it well, thoroughly. After mixing, we have to add, at 0 minute, we have to take a drop of this solution. The first test tube. So after addition of 0.5 drop, so this is positive test with the starch. Now we have to repeat same procedure after 1 minute. Again we have to check whether the color is shown or not. Again there is presence of change in the color. Again we have to repeat same procedure after 1 minute. Now there is slightly color is changing. So very little change. Again, after 1 minute, we have to add. Now here, we have to change. We have to check the color. It is very slight change. Now there is no change in the color. Achromic point is observed. We have to check it. Here is completely blue color.
slight change, little slight change, and here there is a completely absence of the color. So we can conclude that after 4 minutes there is development of a chromic point is observed. So we can conclude that after few minutes there is complete digestion of starch occurs due to the salivary amylase present in the saliva solution. So here the acromic point that is observed at 4th minute, we can say.
After performing the practical, we got the observation that is acromic point is achieved with the iodine solutions. So amylase digest starch by catalyzing hydrolysis yield polysaccharide of gradually diminishing molecular size and ultimately acrodextrin and maltose. The presence and absence of the starch can be confirmed by iodine test. Starch gives blue color in the first test tube. Further, in subsequent test tubes, color gradually changes from blue to violet and red, and then no color thereafter. So we have observed that after first two test tube there is no color with the iodine solution. So in this way starch gradually converted to acrodextrin and maltose, which gives acromic points. So end result, salivary amylase present in saliva catalyzes the starch, shows various color changes with the iodine test. The time taken to achieve the acromic point is about 4 minutes. Now student, we will see some viva hook questions. Very first of all, objective questions. What is salivary amylase? So salivary amylase is an hydrolytic enzyme which is secreted by salivary gland. Now the next question. What are the different products of hydrolysis of starch by salivary amylase? So we have seen starch after complete hydrolysis. Starch is hydrolyzed gradually, and during this it shows conversion of starch to amylodextrin, then erythrodextrin, and finally we got acrodextrin and maltose. So these are the different hydrolytic products of the starch. Reaction of iodine with starch produces which color? So here starch when reacted with the iodine, that shows blue color. What is the another name for salivary amylase? So ptyalene is the another name for the salivary amylase. What is the end product of hydrolysis of starch by salivary amylase? So the end product of hydrolysis of starch is acrodextrin and maltose, which shows no color with the iodine solution. Next question. Write the principle involved in the activity of salivary amylase on starch. Starch is hydrolyzed by salivary amylase. All of you familiar that salivary amylase is an alpha amylase that catalyzes hydrolysis of alpha-1,4 glycosidic linkage in amylose and amylopectins. The hydrolysis of starch yields various polysaccharide of gradually diminishing molecular size, ultimately acrodextrin and maltose. So various stages of hydrolysis that will give different color changes with iodine solution. Starch initially shows blue color, amylodextrin gives violet, violet to red by erythrodextrin, and acrodextrin and maltose that shows no color with the iodine solution. So this is the basic principle to see, to observe the acromic point. Various MCQs. Very first of all, salivary amylase is a type of, yes, carbohydrate, enzyme, lipid, none of the above. Correct option is here, enzyme. Second MCQ is activity of salivary amylase on starch is tested by Benedict test, Polish test, iodine test, and barcode test. So correct option is here, that is iodine test. What are the end product of hydrolysis of starch by salivary amylase? So maltose, acrodextrin, erythrodextrin, both A and B. Correct option is here, both A and B. Another MCQ. Salivary amylase is the enzyme. So it is oxidative, hydrolytic, reactive, none of the above. Correct option is here, hydrolytic. The other name of salivary amylase is xylene, inulin, dextrin, none of the above. Correct option is here, xylene. So thank you.